Listen, I know you've heard that you need to drink more water in order to meet your weight loss goal, but it just feels hard to drink so much. So, what do? Resign yourself to a life of running to the bathroom every 30 minutes? Give up and hope you might still lose weight anyways? Go on the internet to ask your favorite fitness instructor if you can pretty please count coffee and tea too? I get it. Drinking enough water is something I have struggled with since forever. I mean, when I was 11 years old, one of my New Year's resolutions was to drink more water. But I've come up with a super simple, straightforward process that helps me drink my water every day. Hey, Killer Bees, it's Paula B, your best middle-aged fitness friend. And around here, we are all about making peace with your menopausal body by finding a healthy weight and moving in ways that feel like self-love. And if you are aiming for a healthy weight, one of the five things that you need to be doing every day is drinking the right amount of water. And just in case you don't already know why it's so important to drink water, let me lay it out for you real quick. Every single process in your entire body, and I mean this literally, all of the things that your body does require water in some way. If you're not drinking enough, your body has to make decisions about which processes aren't going to get done properly. And some of the first processes that it shuts down are things like digestion and higher level decision making. So yeah, when you're trying to lose weight but not drinking enough water, your brain has a hard time making healthy choices and your body isn't moving food through your system efficiently. So no wonder the scale goes up when you're dehydrated. But here's the crazy thing. You probably already kind of knew that. I mean, on some level, you are definitely aware of the fact that you need to drink water, that it's good for you, that it can help you lose weight. But it's hard to drink more. Well, my friends, there are two reasons why. Reason number one, more is a moving target. My friend, even though you are super smart and incredibly capable of nuanced thinking, there's a part of your brain, that part that actually drives habitual behavior, that some scientists call like the lizard brain or the primitive brain, that still totally thinks in very concrete black or white, all or nothing ways. And that word more has no meaning to that part of your brain. In fact, your lizard brain is completely paralyzed from wondering how much is more. More than yesterday, more than other people, more than I want to, more than the ocean, more than one cup. Like, what's more? And that indecision leads us to doing nothing different and just drinking what we're already familiar with. But there's a really simple fix for this. Here's the process. Step one, calculate exactly how much water you need to be drinking. And this formula is really easy. You take your body weight in pounds and divide by 2 for the number of ounces you should drink daily. So for example, if you weigh 150 pounds, you'd drink 75 ounces. Step two is to divide that total up in ways that make sense for your day. Maybe 11 ounces every hour for the first 7 hours of your day. Maybe 25 ounces each with breakfast and lunch and dinner. Whatever works for you. And once you have that figured out, step three is to put it on your calendar. For reals, like set an alarm, put it on your Google Calendar, write it on your to-do list, keep it front and center in your mind. And then step four, drink the water. That all sounded really simple and motivating until that last step, right? Why is that? You guys, reason number two why drinking water is hard. You're telling yourself it's hard, and you think that's true. Now, I know you can find lots of evidence to support this. There are plenty of people who would agree with you. I agree with you sometimes. But there are also lots of people for whom drinking water isn't a big deal at all. There are even people who get told by their doctors to drink less because, yes, drinking too much water is actually a thing. What I'm getting at here is that drinking water is hard is simply your opinion. And it's not one that's helping you drink enough water. So, how do you overcome that? Well, my friends, you put two more sneaky little steps into our simple process. You're still gonna calculate the right amount and divide it up in ways that make sense. But then, hidden step 2A is that you make a list of all the reasons why you don't wanna drink water. And I mean this literally, make a list. Like get out a pen and paper and ask yourself, why don't I want to drink water? And then let your brain pour out all the reasons why. I don't like it. It's boring. It doesn't taste good. It's too cold. It's too room temperature. I just put on lipstick and don't want to ruin it. I don't want to spend all day peeing. I'll do it later. I don't have time right now. None of the glasses are clean. I don't like the taste of plastic. The water purifier is a hassle to refill. I know you know these. Write them all down. Then you'll still do step three of putting on your calendar, but here is hidden step 3A. Expect to feel resistance when it's time to drink. This is the thing that's been the biggest game changer for me. When you put this step on the list, like it's an item that you're simply expect to check off, it takes all the drama out of it. And it's almost like playing a game to see which excuse your brain is going to offer you this time. So the alarm on your phone goes off, it's time to drink water, and you think to yourself, oh, I'll just do that later. If you hadn't made that list in hidden step 2A, you might be inclined to simply agree with yourself. I mean, it sounds logical, and in the moment, you certainly mean to drink later. But now, you're on to your own tricks. You know that's one of the excuses you use on yourself. And bonus, now you can check it off the list. Hidden step 3A has been accomplished, and you can move on to step 4, which is drink the water. Anyway, so simple. You guys, these are the kinds of topics that we explore every single week on the Fitness Matters podcast. And here on screen, I've got one of my favorite episodes for you to check out. It's a further explanation of how our brains react to ideas like more and enough. Click on it right now, and I'll see you over there.